What is going on, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. This is going to be a different type of video. I want to share with y'all what could possibly have been my worst mistake of a purchase I've ever made in my life. So here we are in my little shop. As you can see, I'm turning my tool chest into a bait stop and get organized, and I'm gonna have to find a different place for all my tools. Anyway, thank y'all for being here. This is Heavy Z Fishing. So, here we go. This is my inflatable kayak. It comes from the company Boat, as you see, B-O-T-E, Boat, okay? So this is it. It's called the Boat Lono. See, Lono. See Lono right there? Arrow inflatable, okay? It's a 3-in-1 basically, okay? It's a 3-in-1. So you got, it's like a hybrid kayak, hybrid canoe, and it's like a hybrid stand-up paddleboard. Really cool, man. Their advertising was really cool, and I was like, why not? So at the time I bought this, okay, at the time I bought it, I was in a Honda Civic. I was driving a freaking car, and I wanted to start this channel, and I'm like, but I have a car. Hey, Boat's like, yo, inflatable, stow it in your trunk. And I'm like, hell yeah, why not? Give it a shot. Well, famous last words. So it all comes in this bag, okay? Everything you see right here, this part, that's like the back part that goes on the back. That's my chair, the kayak, everything fits in here once you deflate it and everything. So this is my second one, okay? And sorry about being outside with the wind, but I don't like to bash any company. I don't. But this included all the accessories, everything. I was out the door about $3,000, okay? I just sold my house, and I was like, you know, screw it. Here I go. They advertise it as really tough, and it could take a beating, and da-da-da. I'm not bashing the company Boat. I'm bashing this product they have. Is that bashing Boat? Okay, whatever. I will say this before I start ripping off into how bad of a purchase this was. I will say that Boat, their customer service is amazing. Absolutely amazing. So my first one I had, my first boat I had a leak that came in this seam right here, okay? And I tried to patch it. They send you a patch kit because obviously you have a inflatable kayak. So I tried to patch it, okay? And it just didn't work, okay? It wasn't working. I couldn't hold air, and I wanted to fish. So, you know, I hit them up. They tried to walk me through it. It wouldn't work. So they sent me a brand new one. They paid for the shipping for my old one. They swapped it out, bam, bam, okay? Awesome, that's great. I did try to get my money back, I did. And unfortunately, it was outside of the 30 or 60 day, whatever return policy, so. Anyway, granted, that first kayak I had, I only used it 5 or 6 times, and then this issue happened, okay? So here we go. I've taken this out about 3 or 4 times now. I've only had it for about 2 months. I already suffered one hole right here. As you see, I already patched it up, and it worked out just fine. This side holds air. Now, all of a sudden, this whole panel right here, okay, is not holding air. And we're about to air it up. I'm going to show you how I do it. But right now, this is not holding air. And
I couldn't hear what you said.
Shut up, Siri. This is not holding air, and I don't know why. So we will try to figure it out. But here we go. Anyways, I want to get my truck started up because I have a automatic air pumper that goes in there. And I also have, it comes with the manual air pump, but I'm going to show y'all how this works, okay? You know, the one day I tried to do a video, there's dogs barking and freaking trucks running. Oh well, what can you do? This is the trouble side. This is the manual pump here. So make sure this valve is sticking up. Come on now, there it goes. Take this, stick it on there, and then you just pump it to your desired PSI. This one, I like to have 8. So it has a dual action here. So that means every up pump and down pump, you're getting air put into it. So I can do this with one hand pretty easily. Take this at the 8 PSI. Okay, take it over to single action. And there you go. Okay. Again, I apologize about the wind. But as you can see, here it is. I mean, it's actually really cool. And that's about all this boat is. It's just cool, okay? I'm gonna go over some pros and cons a little bit more later, but right now I'm just trying to figure out why this left side is not holding air. As of right now, it's holding air. And as you can see, once it's filled up to the PSI that you want, it's actually pretty hard and durable. But for some reason, I've been losing air throughout the day, and I don't know why. So I got my spray bottle here, and I'm just going to go around and spray and see if I see any air bubbles pop up where they shouldn't be. There's a couple right there, but I think that's just the wind blowing it. Okay, so I have sprayed the whole seam down, this seam right here. I sprayed around here where that takes in the air. I have sprayed the down seam. I sprayed everything. I don't see any bubbles coming up from me spraying on the seams and where there could be an issue. There's no holes anywhere, and it's holding air, okay? And this was, I literally had this boat out 2 days ago when I was fishing. That video will be coming up in the near future. But over time, you know, it was losing air. And it was becoming squishy, and they also give you a air valve tool. So you put the tool on and you righty tighty lefty loosey. I put it on there, try to tighten it. It was already tight, so I don't think that's the issue. But as of right now, it's good. Okay, but here's a layout. Okay, here is the seat, which always this right here. Always comes undone, so that will end up coming undone, and then I'm constantly going back, and it's really uncomfortable. But then, you know, that's just a slight issue, probably, who knows. But as you see, it has a latch point here, there's a latch point down there, another one down there, and then there's a latch point here, latch point there, and then two latch points right here and right here. This right here is where the pedal drive goes, which I have up in my garage, but I did not seat this correctly, so I'm not going to show y'all the pedal drive. The pedal drive is okay. It's called the Apex pedal drive. So basically, you just end up popping this out. If I can get it out. You pop that out. It anchors in right here. The pedal drive anchors in right there. Okay, then it comes in and it seats in, and then you just latch it down. The pedal drive is okay. It's pretty tough. It weighs about 20 pounds, 15, 20 pounds. It's metal, except for the propellers are plastic. And I haven't had much issues with that, except for one of the pedals itself keeps on coming loose all the time, and that's why I have my Allen wrench here to constantly tighten it up. Over here, you know, they have these two little nets, which are, they're convenient, I will say that. Over here I have, you know, I got my pliers, my little scissors, and I have my fish grips over here. And then over here on this side, I usually hold some soft plastics or whatever. There's not much storage on this thing, okay? Not much storage.
back here, that's where they have their own cooler called a Kula. That sits in right here. I don't use that whenever I go fishing. I put my backpack full of all my baits in right here. And right here, as you see, it has these two inserts. Bam, bam, and that's where your rod holder goes. And it has one that goes out 45 degrees almost on both sides for, I guess, what they would call trolling. And then two in the middle. So you hold four rods right here. I usually take five and lay one right here along the side. So I take five rods. For fresh, I bass fish. I fish freshwater stuff. So these that come off to the side constantly are getting hung up in trees whenever I'm close to shore. This right here, this is the rudder, as you see right here. And if you need to stow it, go up right here, bring this down, and now it's stowed. Okay. Okay, for the redneck in me, okay, this has to be the coolest part. As you see, there is a what they call their magnetopod right here. This is a magnet. And it has that M right there, magnetopod. And on the bottom of this, as you see, it says magnetopod, and it literally sticks there. I've seen ads where they turn the boat upside down and it does not come off. So that's, I don't ever use it because I don't ever take this, but it's pretty cool, okay? As y'all can see, it is losing air. It's been about 2 hours and I can squeeze in that thing pretty easily. This side's way more firm. Way more firm. This side, losing air. So, I don't know what's causing it. But yeah. And that's it. That sums it up. The boat, this inflatable kayak, is just cool. And that's all it is. Reliable? No. Fishable? Eh. I've caught a lot of fish out of it, but, and I'm a crappy fisherman, so it does catch fish, okay? Storage? No. Made for freshwater? Not really. I see this as more of a saltwater rig, and I think that's what it was made for, but it's just bad, okay? It's just not good. It's not good for somebody like me. I mean, I'm a kayaker, so us kayakers typically beat the crap out of our equipment, and this thing just doesn't hold up, okay? This is my second one in less than a year, less than 6 months. Let's see, September, October, November, December, yeah. About 6 months I've had, already had two of these, and it just, they don't hold up, okay? So I think this right here is just to show you that don't believe in all the cool advertising and that it's tough and blah, 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 because they're good at advertising. I will give them that. They're very good at advertising, and they got me, which I'm very not happy about. And I think this is more suited for the person who wants to go take their rig down, this boat down to the bay or to the ocean, or maybe go freshwater fishing in a pond or something, not in a major lake. And maybe they take it out three times a year and that's it. For me, I'm fishing almost 2 to 3 times a month. I hope, or not even sometimes, but I try, and it's just not made for that. The price I think is outrageous now after having it. Because at the door, once you get all the accessories for it, you're paying right over $3,000, which, I mean, in my situation where I was in, it was okay, because I had a car and I was still able to kayak fish from a Honda Civic. And I just stowed the bag in my trunk, had the rods in my car, everything was great. I got the truck now, ended up getting this car or this truck. I had no idea I was getting it when I bought the boat. So I wish now I had a regular Rotomola hard plastic Hobie or native native watercraft or a any other major brand of kayaks. I wish I would have, you know, had that now. And so here's a this is just a caution for me, and we'll see later if that side panel holds up air or not. So we'll see. Also, let's say, on top of the fishability that I already said, this thing is light, okay? It's maybe,
not even 100 pounds once it's all loaded out, okay? So the wind, we already know if you fish a kayak, wind is not heavy winds. Like I'm saying, anything above 5 miles per hour for this boat, you're getting pushed around, okay? It's just light, and that part sucks. So that's not good for the fishability. The storage, storing this kayak is an A++++, just for the fact that you can fold it up, put it in that bag, and then store it anywhere you want. That part is great, okay? Overall, I'm a frustrated customer, and I would say that it sucks. It just sucks for the way I use it, okay? It might be different for other people in the way they use it, but for my use as a kayaker, as a bass fishing YouTube guy, it sucks. It's not great, okay? The customer service, boats customer service is out of this world. It's great. They're always replying back. They don't try to whatever, but it's good, okay? And, but yeah, not a happy customer.